The Minister of Finance carried out an assessment of project performance in order to ascertain non-performing projects.
Most likely some of these projects could be in our constituencies. We cannot consider the BOFP where government wants to cancel 17 projects and they are not elaborated. And if you put it in Ugandan monetary terms, 1.4 trillion, 1.2 trillion equals 4.4 trillion. 457 billion equals 1.6 trillion already spent on these projects. They want to cancel another expenditure. So we want to know in clear terms which are these projects which you have targeted and you want to cancel.
Therefore, the interest of those very people who are working in the various sectors, so that this game, the budget game of giving, give me more money, because everybody who comes every day is looking for more money. Whether that money is for priority, which has been stated by the government, or not, people want more money, and they don't want to lose anything. That's why even today, I saw a great contradiction here. We are saying projects are not performing. Honorable Katuntu has given you the numbers, and those are bordering the correct numbers, although it is not completely accurate, but bordering there.
This revelation prompted MPs Mwanga Chivumbi and Barnabas Tinkasimire, who tasked the Minister of Finance to table the list of the contracts that are headed for cancellation and what happens to the funds already spent on these projects. The task force revealed all the projects to be cancelled.
Because you would go after rural education, water in the rural areas, we want to know, we cannot regulate.
The chairman, the Muzizi hydropower project, where they have spent a substantial amount of money, and when we approached the minister for energy, they are developing a cold feet. People were mobilized, and their properties were valued for compensation 3 years ago, and now because of this, we are trying to remobilize them to repossess their own land, saying the government is withdrawing.
Ramadan Gobi, Secretary to Treasury, however, called out the hypocrisy showed by the MPs, wondering why they were complaining about stalled projects.
Because it is in your constituency, you say, that analysis cannot apply. On one hand, you are saying we need to get the projects performed so that we are able to get the services to the people. On the other hand, you are saying, you are very people, where the project is not taking off, like Honorable Tinkasimire, the project is talking about Muzizi, has been in the pipeline since 2013.
But this one tells you that we need to streamline our planning. If we have promised people to do something, we must do it up to, we execute it up to the end.
But budget committee members have raised concerns over the 465.4 billion shillings which have been allocated to the parish development model.
Your duty in finance, to just keep quiet, sir. I thought you analyze and say this is okay, or say this is not a good idea. Absolutely. But not to keep quiet like we are dealing with the mafia system.
To ensure that the priorities that you have given us as the key things we must focus on are funded without necessarily going to borrow money, because we don't have that space, a lot of it, to do that.
Committee members have protested relocation of 205 billion for wealth funds, including Women Enterprise Program, planting materials under NADS, Luero, Renzori and coffee seedlings under UCD to fund the parish model, saying parish model should not come at the cost of other programs.